It's time for Real Estate 101 with the Karey Brown team from Realty Executives Preferred Advisors.
Good Sunday morning to you. This is Karey Brown, broker owner of Realty Executives Preferred Advisors, and you're listening to Real Estate 101. Thanks for joining us. And today I am here with Angel Romero with United Way of Greater Topeka. So, Angel, thank you so much for joining me.
Thanks so much for having me. I'm glad to be here.
There's a lot to talk about. So, with United Way, obviously you guys do so many great things with focusing on education, income, health, all the building blocks of quality of life.
Absolutely.
Got that right off their site, by the way. Let's talk about, you've got this great fundraising campaign going.
Sure.
Let's talk about that.
Sure, yeah. So, you know, we're really excited. Every year we get to talk with individuals and companies all throughout the community about ways that they can support United Way. And that's really the best part of my job, is that I get to talk with folks all around the community about our work and about how they can support it. So every year we engage about 300-some companies throughout our community, large, very large companies and companies down to companies that are very small, to talk about how they can support our work and workplace campaign. So we set a goal at the beginning of our campaign year to raise $2.75 million for our workplace campaign. So that campaign started on July 1st of 2017 and will go all the way through June 30th of 2018. So right now we've collected about $2.3 million towards that goal. So we are just $400 away from making that $2.75 million. So we
Wow.
are really, really excited about the progress that we're making there. We tell people, too, you can keep up with our progress on the campaign if you go to unitedwaytopeka.org/impact2017. We have a thermometer on there that people can not only keep track of the dollars raised, but what those dollars will do in the community.
That is amazing. Speaking of different things that you guys do for the community, you've got a community impact grants. What are those?
We do. So, you know, what we do through United Way, we are kind of a convening organization. So we bring organizations together because we know that all the challenges that we address in education, health, financial stability, those are really big challenges. And we know that they're too big for any one organization to do on their own. So we kind of bring organizations together, and then we grant out funds to those organizations. We have about 27 funded partners throughout the community that we provide funds to. So in order to do that, we issue what we call requests for proposals, RFPs, that go out to organizations who have missions that align with our strategies in each of those areas. And we actually release those results on Friday, or those RFPs, excuse me, on Friday. And so organizations had a chance to come and learn about the RFP process, learn about the grant application process, and then be able to start working on their grants. And so they'll spend the next month working on those grant applications and then getting them turned into us. So that's a process that we know organizations are very excited to take on. We have a lot of partners who've worked with us for a long time. So they're excited to take that on. And then the other really cool part, one of my favorite features of United Way's work, is that any funding decision made about funding our agencies actually isn't made by the staff at United Way, but it's made by volunteers. So we have volunteers that come together for funding panels. And so those volunteers get to review all those applications, and then they come to our office for a day for kind of a facilitated session. And then they are the ones that get to talk amongst themselves and get to then decide on how those funds are spent in the community. So it takes a lot of volunteers to make that happen.
That's amazing. So there are so many different entities that go into, or different programs that go into United Way. Mm-hmm. One of the ones I'd like to talk about is the 211 Impact.
Sure. So 211 is actually a national initiative of United Way, and it's a really, really great resource that we have right here in our community. So what 211 is an information resource line that folks can call 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. And the whole purpose of 211 is to connect people with resources in their community. So anyone can call the phone line, and they could call for anything from, you know, I really need help learning how to potty train my child, or I'm in a lot of debt and I just don't know how to get out of it, or where is there child care in our community? You know, any kind of those life questions or those needs that people have in their lives, they can call 211 at any time, and they'll connect them to resources right here in our community. And people can also go online to the 211 website and access that information online as well.
Absolutely. I know definitely during the winter and, you know, with the rising utility bills and
Absolutely.
Stuff like that, there is utility assistance.
Mm-hmm.
And so they get you to the right resources to
Absolutely.
Make that happen. So definitely look into that. Housing, so many different things. It's
Absolutely.
Amazing.
Yeah, we do. United Way has that focus in education, health, and financial stability. And those are what we call our impact areas. But kind of the foundation to all that is basic needs. And so while we fund partners in those three impact areas, we also do work in basic needs, because because we know that, you know, a child who's hungry can't possibly focus in school. And if you can't pay your rent and utilities, you can't really think about being financially stable and having a budget and all that. So we also fund and partner with organizations in basic needs, too, so we can provide that foundational support that we know people need.
That is amazing. So with it being tax season, you guys have also got a really cool thing going on. Let's talk about that.
Yeah. So we have another partnership with our the United Way national office is MyFreeTaxes.com. So with tax season coming upon us, this is everyone's friendly reminder that we're just about a month or so away from the tax deadline. People can go to MyFreeTaxes.com. It's a free tool. It's available to be used by anyone that has an income level that's right around the $60,000 mark or lower. So it's available to actually a broad range of individuals. And it's a free income tax preparation tool. So you can file your federal and state returns on there and be able to do everything you could through the TurboTax or H&R Block type programs, but do it for free. And that's something that's made possible through that partnership between us and the United Way worldwide headquarters.
That's awesome. So again, so many different programs. Let's talk about the Born Learning Program.
Yeah. So this is not only one of my favorite programs, but also kind of what got me to United Way. I started as a volunteer on a Born Learning Trail project a long time ago, and then that kind of sparked my interest in United Way. So what the Born Learning Trails are is really kind of this recognition that kids are born learning, that we know that 80% of a child's brain is developed by age 3. And so there's so much critical development that happens in those first few years of a child's life. And one of United Way's goals is to have kids that are ready to start kindergarten by the time they get to school. So those Born Learning Trails help us do those. They are outdoor trails that consist of 10 stations. And at each station, there's a sign that directs a child and their parent or caregiver on an activity to do. And it's a fun activity that's really designed to get the parent and the caregiver, or the parent and the child, to interact in a fun way. But in a way that's also helping them build those critical skills that they need to start kindergarten. So there's one station where there's shapes on the ground, for instance, and the sign says, point at the shapes on the ground. What shapes do you see? What color are they? Another station has a hopscotch area, and you get to talk about math and numbers. Another station has letters on the ground. You know, what are some words that start with that letter? Again, things that are all fun for the child and their parent, but it's helping that child learn and build that capacity as well. So we currently have three trails in the community. Our first one, kind of the Cadillac of Born Learning Trails, is at the Pine Ridge Prep Preschool over in the Pine Ridge Public Housing Neighborhood in East Topeka. And then two that were recently just finished, both at the CRC Care Center at Avondale East and Highcrest, and then in the Montero Neighborhood in Southeast Topeka.
Amazing. Let's talk about Neighborhood Opportunity for Wellness. What all is that? What all does that encompass?
Sure. So the NOW initiative, as we like to call it, this was a really exciting opportunity that came to us through the Kansas Health Foundation, actually, through a grant from them. And the whole purpose of the program is really how do we empower residents that live in our public housing neighborhoods. So we, through the NOW initiative and through the grant dollars we received, we've been working for the past 2 years on this initiative, on implementing it in three housing areas, in the Pine Ridge Housing Neighborhood, Deer Creek and Echo Ridge. So three Topeka Housing Authority neighborhoods where we know that there's some significant challenges. You know, we know in two of those neighborhoods, the average yearly income is about $9,000 a year. And we know in Echo Ridge, it's just about $12,000 a year. And these are folks who do have families, sometimes with multiple children. We know that there's also a high percentage of single-parent female head of household neighborhoods in those areas. We also know that those are neighborhoods where the unemployment rate is relatively low. And so what that tells us is that while folks are not making much, they are oftentimes working many jobs to meet those needs. And so there's not really a huge unemployment problem, but there's significant underemployment challenges. And when we know when there's parents that are working multiple jobs, the strain that puts on their family presents a lot of challenges. And so we knew that there was lots of work to be done there. The beauty of the program, though, is that instead of us coming in and telling residents, well, this is what you need to do and this is what a successful neighborhood looks like, the program really works to empower the residents. And so we had these kind of community conversations with residents and talked to them about what do you want to see your community look like. You know, it's hard sometimes at first for public housing residents to really kind of think and take ownership in a community. community. Thankfully, the Topeka Housing Authority is really intentional on engaging their residents and really wants them to be involved and be a part of what they do. So we really worked with them to think about and kind of brainstorm, what would the future of your community look like? What would it look like to improve the community for you? And so based off of those conversations, we developed a community action plan, which has several steps and several things we want to see, that residents want to see implemented in those communities. And then we work with the residents to implement that program. And so it's interesting, too. You know, sometimes we have these big grand ideas and visions of what people want to see, but some of the things were really simple. You know, having speed bumps in the neighborhood. Deer Creek is right adjacent to Highland Park High School. And so people can drive through that side street really quick, and they just wanted people to slow down because there's kids playing there. You know, things that we wouldn't have necessarily thought of, that residents said are really important to them. So it's a very resident-driven, resident-led process. There's a resident advisory council that kind of gets to oversee this work and gets to help coordinate events in the neighborhoods. So it's a really exciting way for us to really dig deep into neighborhoods and really be involved with that work on kind of the ground floor level, and really help people take charge of that work, help the people living in the community really kind of own that work, so that it can be successful and sustainable. You know, we know that if we just go in there and start telling people this is how it is, that work, one, isn't going to be very effective and isn't going to be received well and probably won't last long. And so we really, with all of our work, want it to be long-term work that's very sustainable work as well.
Absolutely. Speaking of which, whenever it comes to the aging community, you guys have got, you reach out in several different ways. And one of the ones that I thought would be worth, obviously they're all worth sharing, but very important to share, would be prescription medications.
Sure. So, you know, within our basic needs work we do, we have four areas of basic needs services that we provide. So we provide assistance in food, in rent and utility assistance, in protection from domestic violence, and healthcare and prescription access. So the healthcare and prescription access one we know is probably more important now than ever before, with the rising costs of prescription medications and healthcare in general. We know that that's an area that's really important for a lot of individuals. So our work in basic needs and healthcare prescription access allows individuals, many of whom might be seniors, get access to the prescriptions that they need. And we work with organizations throughout the community, one of them being Health Access, which is an organization that's able to provide free or reduced cost medical care to seniors and others in the community in order to be able to address those conditions that have been plaguing individuals for a long time, to be able to keep them on the medications that they need so that they can have healthy and successful lives. And we know it impacts the community as a whole, too. When people aren't relying on the emergency room as their primary care physician, that helps our community. We saw recently actually where there's a situation where the hospitals were almost at capacity with their emergency rooms. And so we know, especially with the flu going on right now, too, that anything that we can do to help reduce that burden on hospitals and to get people into regular care and preventative care and getting things before they become emergencies is really critical. And especially at prescription assistance is very important for folks, not only in Shawnee County, but also in Jackson County as well. We provide basic needs assistance to individuals in Jackson County through United Way. And so we know that work up there is having an impact on folks too. We heard from one individual in Jackson County who told us that she had been struggling for a while with mental health challenges. And she had been to a physician once, and the physician told her that, yeah, I think in order to get this under control, I advise you to see a therapist, see someone on a regular basis, and there's probably a course of medication that would be helpful. But this individual knew she couldn't afford that. And it wasn't until she was able to receive the assistance grant through the prescription assistance that we provide in Jackson County that she was finally able to see a therapist for the first time, and then was able to access the medication that she needs, and tells us now that she feels better than she ever has before. And so we see things like that happening and know that that's making a big impact.
That is amazing. So be sure and join us after the break. Here is a word from our sponsors.
This is Stephen Parkin at Invista Credit Union. Purchasing a home is one of the most exciting and important decisions someone can make. Let me tell you why Invista is the best choice for financing your new home purchase. First, quick pre-approval process. Our fast decision-making gives you the power to act quickly and make an offer on your dream home. Second, local servicing. We service your mortgage in-house. You won't get a long-distance runaround, but a committed professional whose only job is to help you. Third, experienced team. We are dedicated to simplifying the process and educating you through the home buying process. Come by Invista. It's okay to dream. In fact, it's encouraged. We are your home buying partner. Give us a call at 785 228-0149.
Southwest Topeka has a good neighbor. State Farm agent Jim Garrison, now at 29th and Urish. If your current insurance situation has you going around in circles, get off the roundabout and stop in and meet Jim and his wonderfully efficient staff. Let Jim Garrison give you a quote and make the Garrison comparison. He's confident that with State Farm's competitive rates, the right coverage, and his unmatched service, you'll want to make him your new insurance agent. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there, and Jim Garrison is there for you, northeast of the roundabout at 29th and Urish.
Thanks for joining us again. This is Karey Brown, broker owner of Realty Executives Preferred Advisors, and you're listening to Real Estate 101. And I am back with Angel Romero, and Angel is with United Way. We've been talking, before the break, we were talking about prescription medications for the older generation, and there's also another program that's for everybody, correct?
Sure, yeah. So through our national partnership with United Way, we have a program called FamilyWise, which is available to anyone in the community. The only condition on it is it can only be used for individuals who either have no insurance coverage or who are taking prescriptions that aren't covered by their current insurance. And what it is, it's a prescription discount program. And so if you have a medication that's not covered on your insurance program, or if you just have no insurance coverage at all, it allows you to get deep discounts on those prescriptions. So we've seen individuals who've received discounts of upwards of 70% off of a lot of the prescriptions that they take, and especially individuals who've told us that they're taking really expensive cancer medications like that for chronic conditions that can cost a lot of money. And through the FamilyWise program, they're able to receive some really deep discounts. And when individuals go to the FamilyWise website, they can actually look up different prescriptions on there and see what the cost of the prescription would be with the discount. So it's not an insurance program, but it is a discount program. So folks can actually go to the website. They can look up prescriptions on there. They can also, when they register, it's free to register on the website. They'll receive a card that they can print out, and that's a card that they can take to their pharmacy to redeem the discounts on those prescriptions. But again, it's one of those things, as we know, that the rising cost of prescriptions has hit a lot of individuals. It's a great resource. And again, the only condition is just as long as you either don't have insurance, or even if you do have insurance, but you have prescriptions that aren't covered by your insurance, you can utilize the benefits of that program.
So it's not a secondary. So, right. You know, if the insurance is paid for, you're not going to come in and finish the rest.
Right,
it's only
exactly.
If it's not covered.
Yeah.
Gotcha. So you guys also partner with HCCI and the HOPE program. Let's talk about that.
Sure. So HCCI stands for Housing and Credit Counseling Incorporated. So they are one of our funded partners under our financial stability impact area. So in financial stability, our emphasis in our work is on how do we get individuals to be able to manage their finances, to learn about healthy financial planning, healthy financial habits. We kind of covered a whole spectrum of the community, from students and teaching them about what it looks like to have successful financial habits, all the way up to adults. And so HCCI and the HOPE program is a program that really targets adults in our community. And it's really meant for folks who have found themselves in really difficult financial situations for lots of reasons. Sometimes it's individuals who have just accrued a lot of debt in their lives, or folks who have had no savings, or have had some life situation happen that maybe has wiped out their entire savings, and people that have found themselves upside down in their finances in some way. And so what the HOPE program does is it allows volunteer mentors to work with those individuals over the course of about 6 weeks on a financial mentoring program. And so through those 6 weeks, those individuals learn all kinds of things about successful financial management and how to budget, how to save money, how to do all those things that we know are really important for managing your finances. And then after they complete the program, what we found is that a lot of those individuals who've gone through the program often return back as mentors themselves because the program has impacted them and made a really big difference in their lives. And so they kind of want to pay it forward and be able to help other individuals in the program as well. One of the things that's really interesting, too, that we found about the HOPE program is that I think sometimes folks have a kind of conception in their mind of who they think needs financial services or who they think might be having financial difficulties. But what the program will tell you is that they see folks who are low-income residents, but they also see folks who also are high-income folks who make a lot of money but have not managed it well or have no idea how to manage their money. So while they might be making a lot of money, they have next to no savings, or they may be accrued a lot of debt in college, and so that's preventing them from doing things like buying a home or doing some other things that we know are really important. So that program helps individuals kind of on the whole spectrum in our community and helps them build those successful habits that we know are really important for individuals to be able to have successful lives.
I've had Chris Burke on the show several times, and we also, through my company, basically anybody that we have that comes in that isn't able to get financed for a home, and they're, you know, they really want one, and so there's a learning process that goes into that. We hook them up with housing and credit counseling to help them fix their credit or gain credit. Mm-hmm. You'd be surprised at how quick that process is.
Absolutely.
And just a lot of education pieces, because, you know, not everybody grew up with a household that taught you about budgeting and just how to make that happen. So it's definitely, it's an amazing program. I definitely could not say enough great things about Chris Burke and all the guys over and gals over at Housing and Credit Counseling.
Absolutely.
I'm a huge fan. Absolutely. Just as you do. So let's talk about human trafficking. That is a portion of the United Way's programs. It is a problem.
It is.
And it's a problem that's not far from home.
Absolutely. You know, I think folks would be amazed to learn about the extent of human trafficking, both locally and throughout the state of Kansas. You know, it's a horrible, heartbreaking thing that affects folks right here in our community. One of the things, while human trafficking isn't one of our specific areas that we focus on, it's something that all facets of our work. One of the things that we do is we partner with the Topeka Rescue Mission as one of our funded partner agencies to do some work in our financial stability impact area. And Barry Feeker at the Topeka Rescue Mission has kind of been one of the leaders on addressing the human trafficking issue in our community. And it's kind of become one of the leading authorities in our community on that issue. And the Rescue Mission has really helped countless individuals in our community be able to escape from human trafficking. And the Rescue Mission is really intentional on wanting to reach out to folks. And what they'll tell you is they're seeing that problem grow bigger every year since they've really started their outreach to those victims and been able to try to get them in to get them connected to resources in the community. So we know that that's unfortunately a growing epidemic that we're seeing throughout the United States, but certainly here at home. And so we know that those folks through the Topeka Rescue Mission, through the programs that we fund over there, could be impacted by some of the things that we're doing. So we fund a program at the Rescue Mission called the Care Program. And that is a program that works with individuals who are homeless, some of whom may have been human trafficking victims. And it really focuses on getting those individuals out of homelessness and into a job. And it's a really, really neat program that what it does is it takes those individuals and plugs them into internships in the community at different organizations, kind of based on their interests and their skill set and that sort of thing. And after working at that internship for a period of time, the goal is to then get that person into a permanent job at that organization or at another organization in the community. And I can tell you, I've had the chance to attend the graduation ceremonies for the CARE program, and it's always inspiring to listen to individuals affected by the program and who will tell you how it's really changed their lives. Folks who, again, you know, maybe have been trafficked victims, may have been drug users, had other things that are going on in their lives, were just in a really bad place. And that program has really made a difference by showing them that they're able to find a job and able to sustain themselves and that they're able to find a permanent job. And so that's, you know, one of those facets of our financial stability work is to help people find employment in our community.
Absolutely. And we keep every radio show that we do. And you can actually go out to our YouTube channel with Realty Executives Preferred Advisors Team, or even check out our Facebook page. And we share those. And there's a couple of shows where I've had Barry on, and he goes through all the different things that the Rescue Mission does.
Absolutely.
It's really something everybody here locally should be educated on. It was this huge eye opener. And a lot of the places that they're helping and doing great things at, one of which is Highcrest.
Sure.
And during the break, we were talking about a bus tour that you guys do.
Mm-hmm.
Elaborate on that, would you?
Sure. So one of the I think probably most effective ways that we've been able to offer for people to see our work is through taking what we call these experience impact bus tours. So these tours are 3-hour tours, kind of Gilligan's Island themed. So they are a 3-hour tour of our community work. So starting at the United Way office, and it's really 3 hours of interactive conversations about our work and about needs in the community. So it'll allow folks to see kind of all parts of our community. Oftentimes we hear from people that they've seen areas of our community that they've never seen before or never been to before, and we'll always hear about needs or challenges that they never knew existed in our community. So over the course of those 3 hours, you know, they'll kind of be guided by us, and we'll talk about the places that we work in the community. It's a great place to kind of see our work hands-on and to hear from people that are kind of on the front lines of that work. So they'll get to talk to a number of individuals who are really kind of our hands and feet in the community doing that work. One of the stops that we make a couple stops on the tour. One of them is at the CRC Care Center, which is in the former Avondale East Elementary School in the High Crest neighborhood. And so we use the opportunity to talk about some of our partnerships out there. We partner with the Community Resources Council. CRC is one of our funded partner agencies. And they're the ones that are kind of landlords for Avondale East, and they work with a number of different agencies out there. One of them being NetReach, which is a program of the Topeka Rescue Mission that's really focused on the High Crest neighborhood. They kind of took a look at where do people go after they leave the rescue mission, and they found that that was one of the neighborhoods that a lot of people were settling in. So they really wanted to dig in there and help people basically be able to stay on their own and not have to come back to the mission. So they've done a lot of work to really dig into that neighborhood. We know that there's a lot of challenges in the High Crest neighborhood. One of the challenges that they do run into there is human trafficking, and they will find individuals that have been trafficked, and oftentimes they are children that are being trafficked or being groomed in the process of being trafficked. And so they are really trying to reach out to that community to pull people out of some of those situations and root out a lot of those bad things that are happening in that community. We know that that's a neighborhood where there's a high number of gang affiliations for youth as well. So we know that there's a lot of negative, a lot of corrupting influences that happen in that community that the NetReach program and others in that community are really trying to root out. So on the bus tour, we give the opportunity for bus tour riders to really get out and talk to people that are working in the NetReach program to see the kind of the whole world of things that they are doing out at the former Avondale East School. Out there, there's a number of programs, and they're really working hard in the neighborhood to make a difference in people's lives out there. Everything from parents as teachers programs to work with young parents to programs with the YWCA to the Mirror program that works with fathers that are in arrears on child support and helping them be able to have a role in their family's lives and to be able to help them be successful, have a job, those kinds of things. So a number of different services that are happening out there that bus tour riders get to see. They'll also get to make a stop. They'll get to drive through those neighborhoods that participate in the NOW program that I just mentioned. And they'll actually get to get out at Pine Ridge and see the Born Learning Trail there at Pine Ridge and to see a number of the other things that are happening in that neighborhood. And so it's a really great way to kind of get a sense of all the work that United Way does and really kind of see it firsthand.
Absolutely. And another program that is taking place, and it does encompass a fair amount of High Crest, is the OK program that the police officers have done to put mentors with the young men to bring them up, especially in the homeowners, with the role models typically being the mother. They're not getting enough of the father figure to keep them on the straight and narrow. Not that mamas aren't doing a great job.
Right.
But, you know, when you're a young man, you look to men.
Absolutely.
So they're definitely trying to make a difference there.
Yeah.
So thank you so much, Angel, for joining me.
Glad to be here.
The amazing things you guys do. If you wanted to get involved with United Way, how would they get a hold of you?
Sure. So, you know, they can go to the United Way website, unitedwaytopeka.org, and there's lots of access to information on there. Folks can call my line directly at our office at 785-228-5128. My email is also aromero@unitedwaytopeka.org. So if folks would like to volunteer with us, there are a number of volunteer opportunities. I mentioned the panels that we'll be doing in May are funding panels if they'd like to volunteer through that. For any volunteer opportunities, they can call Kimberly Wolf at our office. Her number is 785-228-5128. 5120. And of course, if people want to give, I mentioned we're just about $400,000 away from that $2.75 million goal. So folks can give right online. They can go to givetopeka.org. And in just about a minute, they can make a gift online to support United Way.
Awesome. And if you're looking to buy or sell, be sure and give us a call at 785-213-5188 or check out our website. It's nekansashomes.com. That encompasses four MLSs from the Kansas City into Kansas City, Missouri, even, all the way out to Junction City, as far north as Nebraska Line, as far south as Emporia. So be sure and check it out. Thanks for joining us on Real Estate 101.
Thank you for listening to Real Estate 101 with the Karey Brown team from Realty Executives Preferred Advisors. Tune in again next Sunday at 11 o'clock for Real Estate 101.